फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल टॉक अबाउट द टॉप प्रोजेक्टाइल मोशन. ओके, नाउ व्हाट इज एक्चुअली प्रोजेक्टाइल मोशन? एन ऑब्जेक्ट इज प्रोजेक्टेड मेकिंग अ सर्टेन एंगल थीटा विद द हॉरिजॉन्टल. ओके, एंड दिस पाथ विच इट फॉलोज इज अ पैराबोलिक पाथ. ओके, नाउ हाउ वी डिसाइड इट इज पैराबोलिक पाथ? बिकॉज ऑन सॉल्विंग द इक्वेशंस वी गेट the final equation of displacement as y equal to alpha x minus beta x square. We get the final equation in this form, and this is the equation of parabola. See, this is our final equation, x tan theta minus half gx square upon u square cos square theta. Okay, and this is of the form this, and so the equation of the path of projectile is nothing but parabola, and so the path of projectile is said to be a parabolic path. Now over here, if you see carefully, the velocity, initial velocity u, can be divided into two components, one along horizontal, one along vertical, and that's why we resolve this u into u cos theta and u sin theta. Now u cos theta will be along x axis, u sin theta will be along y axis. Now during the course of the motion, one of the component, that is a horizontal component, remains unchanged. This u cos theta remains as it is. There is no change in the horizontal component throughout the path. But the u sin theta component is affected by the acceleration due to gravity. And that's why as it goes up, u sin theta goes on decreasing, becomes zero, and then it changes direction. It moves in opposite direction, that is downward direction. So value of u sin theta varies, but u cos theta remains constant. So here I have written the horizontal component is given by ux equal to u cos theta, vertical component is given by uy equal to u sin theta. So always remember these two. One component remains constant, other component is affected by the acceleration due to gravity. Now if you want to find instantaneous velocity, okay, we have to take square root of ux square plus uy square. Now ux square, as you know, is u cos theta, and uy square, okay, can be written as u sin theta minus gt, because it is affected by what? Acceleration due to gravity. So u sin theta minus gt. When you square this, you get the final equation, u square plus g square d square minus 2u gt sin theta. This is the expression for instantaneous velocity. Okay, u instantaneous, magnitude of instantaneous velocity is given by this expression. Further, now how much is the time required to reach maximum height? Okay, time required to reach maximum height, I call it as time of ascent. Time of ascent is given by u sin theta upon g. Okay, u sin theta upon g. Now time of flight is time of ascent and time of descent, which are equal, and so I can write time of flight as 2 times time of ascent, that is 2u sin theta upon g. So this is the expression for what? Time of flight. Now if you see here, if you take ratio of time of flights at two complementary angles, means suppose 30 and 90 minus 30, 90 minus 30 is 60, then the ratio comes out to be t1 by t2 equal to tan theta. Okay, we get t1 by t2 equal to tan theta. That is for complementary angles. So remember this formula, for complementary angles t1 by t2 is tan theta. Now the horizontal range means the maximum distance traveled along the horizontal, along the x-axis, is given by this formula, u square sin 2 theta upon g. And if we take complementary angles, there won't be any change. Like if you take 30 degrees and 60 degrees, both are complementary angles, and the range will be same. So r1 by r2 will remain same, that is 1. Okay, now let's talk about the height reached by the projectile. The maximum height, or the height reached by projectile, is simply given by this formula, u square sin square theta upon 2g. Okay, u square sin square theta upon 2g. And for complementary angles, h1 by h2, okay, the value comes out to be tan square theta. So the important formulas you remember, one is this. This is the expression for projectile motion. Okay, equation of projectile motion is x tan theta minus half gx square upon u square cos square theta. Next is time of flight, 2u sin theta upon g. Horizontal range, u square sin 2 theta upon g. Okay, and height reach, u square sin square theta upon 2g. This is the height reached by the projectile. Now read the numerical 11th carefully. Okay. The numerical says, a body is projected at 30 degrees with the horizontal with velocity 60 meter per second. So theta is 30 degrees and initial velocity is 60 meter per second. And it follows a parabolic path. What will be the magnitude of velocity when it reaches maximum height? Okay. Velocity you have to find when it reaches what? At maximum height. What is the velocity at maximum height? This you have to find. Now, at maximum height, if you just recall, which velocity is present? It's horizontal component or vertical component? I told you, at maximum height, only there will be the vertical component, that is ux. Ux equal to u cos theta. U cos theta, okay. I repeat the question. A body projected at 30 degrees with horizontal with velocity 60 meter per second follows a parabolic path. What will be the magnitude of velocity when it reaches height of 45 meters? Sorry, they are not told you. You have to find velocity at the height of what? At height of 45 meter. But first, I will find the velocity at maximum height. Okay, at maximum height, what is the velocity? But before that, first I will find how, what is the maximum height reached by the projectile. Now, formula for maximum height reached by the projectile is h will be equal to u square sin square theta upon 2g. Okay, that is 60 into 60 into sin square theta. Sin 30 is half, and sin 30 the whole square is 1 by 4 upon 2 into g. Now value of g is taken as 10. What do you get here? So height will be 45, maximum height is nothing but what? 45 meters. And they are asking you to find the velocity at maximum height, right? They have mentioned find velocity at h equal to 45, and h equal to 45 is the maximum height. And so at maximum height, the velocity component, only velocity component will be ux equal to u cos theta, correct? And that's why it will be 60 into cos of what? 30. Cos 30. And cos 30 is what? 60 into root 3 by 2, or 30 root 3. And options are given there. Okay, now root 3 is 1.732. 30 into 1.732, which comes out to be approximately 52 meter per second. So this is our final answer. Now look at numerical 14. I'll read out.
The equation of motion of a projectile are given by x equal to 40 t meter and 2y equal to 96 t minus 9.82 square meter. The angle of projection is dash. So you have to find the angle of projection for this.
See, look at the board. X is given 40 t. I'll find velocity along x axis by differentiating it. I get it as 40 meter per second. Similarly, 2y is 96 t minus 9.80 square. This is the equation along y axis. So I write y equal to 48 t minus 4.9 t square. When you differentiate this, that is dy by dt, what you get is 48 minus 9.8 t. Okay. Now once you got ui, you have to find the velocity at time t equal to 0. So initial velocity, I'll put t equal to 0, what I get is simply 48 meter per second. Okay, I get ux and uy, or I'll write it as vx and vy, whatever you take. I better write here as vx and this as vy. Okay, so I got the values of vx and vy. Now, so angle of projection. Angle of projection will be theta equal to tan inverse vx by, sorry, vy upon vx. And what is this value? Vy is 48. So tan inverse 48 upon 40. And this comes out to be what? 8, 5, 48, 6, 48, tan inverse, okay, 6 by 5. Now tan is what? Opposite side upon adjacent side. So you can understand this in a right angle triangle, okay, tan of theta is opposite side upon adjacent side. So if you want to find hypotenuse, it will be root of 6 square plus 5 square, right? And 36 plus 25 is 61. So this hypotenuse will be what? Root 61, correct? Now, the same way I can write sine theta. Sine theta is 6 upon root 61. Therefore, theta will be sine inverse 6 upon root 61. Okay, so this is our final answer and this is the correct option.
We will solve numerical 12 and numerical 13. Okay, so read these two numericals carefully and then we will solve the both numericals. Okay,
it is mentioned that there are three projectiles A, B and C projected at angles 30 degrees, 45 degrees and 30 degrees, B is projected at theta equal to 45 degrees and C is projected at the angle of 60 degrees. Okay. RA, RB and RC are ranges of AB and C respectively. Then velocity of projection is same for AB and C. Velocity of projection is same and RA, RB and RC are the ranges of all the three projectiles. Range, I told you, is the maximum distance travelled along the horizontal. Now, if you look at the formula which I have written over here, okay, for complementary angles, ratio of the ranges is same, okay, complementary angles, means 30 and 60 are complementary angles. So, in this case, for angle 30 and 60 which are complementary, RA and RC will be equal. RA will be equal to RC. Let us find the value of RA. Okay. Now, range is given by formula U square sine 2 theta upon G. okay? So it becomes u square into sine 60 by 2g. Sine 60 is root 3 by 2. So it will become root 3 by 2 sine 60 by 2g. Okay? Now for 45 degrees, RB will be u square sine 2 times 45, that is sine 90 upon g. Okay? I'm sorry, here it should be simply g. Right? Now, sine 90 is 1, so it is simply u square upon g. Now, if you compare u square upon g and root 3 by 2, this value is smaller and this value is greater. So, what I get? RB is greater than RA and RA is equal to RC. Okay? This will be our correct option, and that is R equal to RC, which is less than RB. So option D should be the correct answer. I'll check it out. Numerical 12. Yes. Option D is our correct answer. Numerical 13. The horizontal range of a projectile fired at an angle of 15 degrees is 50 meter. If it is fired with the same speed at an angle of 45 degrees, its range will be dash. So, the range is 50 meter when theta 1 is, angle is what, 15 degrees. With the same speed, if it is projected at angle of 45 degrees, what will be the range? Now, first of all, make use of the formula. Okay, I'll write R1 equal to u square sine 2 theta upon g. Here I'll put the value. 2 theta will be sine 30. Sine 30 will be what? Half. So I'll write half into u square upon g. This is equation 1. And for R2, I'll write u square sine 45 to the 90 upon g, and that is simply u square upon g. Correct? Now when you take R1 by R2, R1 by R2 will be half u square g upon u square g, that is simply half, or R2 will be twice R1, that is 2 into R1 is 50. And that answer will be what? 100 meters. Okay. So correct answer will be R2 equal to 100 meters. I will check it out. Option or 13th option. Yes, it is C. Correct answer is C.
For numerical 14, you have to simply make use of the formula for instantaneous velocity, which I have already given on the board. Okay. Refer that, and when you put the value of ux and uy, you get the options. Now you look at numerical 15th.
See, we are talking about numerical 15th. They have given you the equation for initial velocity, u equal to I plus 2j, and they are asking you to find the Cartesian equation of the path. Now, you can understand this. I can write this as uxi plus uyj. Okay? There are two components, one along x-axis, one along y-axis. Now, what is ux? Ux is actually velocity component along horizontal, and that is u cos theta, whose value is in this equation 1. Similarly, what is ui? Ui is u sine theta, and whose value here? Ui is what? 2. right? So I know the value of u cos theta and u sin theta. I can find tan theta. Divide this equation 2 by 1. I get tan theta equal to 2 upon 1. Right? Now once you know tan theta, you can individually find sin theta and cos theta, but that is not required at all. We come to the expression for projectile motion. The general equation is y equal to x tan theta minus half g x square upon u square cos square theta. Right? Now we know tan theta is 1, so it will become 2x minus half g x square upon u square cos square theta, and that is again 1. Okay, this value is what? 1. So what we finally get, this g is taken as 10. In the equation they have given that value of g is 10, so it becomes 2x minus 10 upon 2, and this comes out to be simply 2x minus 5x square. Okay, this will be our final answer. 2x minus 5x square.
Numerical 16. A particle is projected with a velocity v so that its horizontal range is twice the greatest height attained. The horizontal range is dash.
See here, horizontal range they have given, r is range, maximum range is twice the maximum height. They are asking you to find r. Okay, now what is the formula for r? R is what? U square sine 2 theta by g. U square sine 2 theta upon g, which is equal to height. Height is given by u square sine square theta upon g. Now what is getting cancelled? U square g 2 will also get cancelled, and what remains is sine 2 theta equal to sine square theta. This I'll write as 2 sine theta cos theta equal to sine square theta. And this will be sin theta upon cos theta, because one sin theta will get cancelled, and sin theta upon cos theta equal to 2. Okay, value of tan theta I get 2. Now what is the meaning of this? Tan theta is 2 by 1, so this value will be square root of 2 square plus 1 square, that is root 5. Hypotenuse will be root 5. Now you can easily tell me what is the value of sin theta. Sin theta will be opposite side upon hypotenuse. This is the value of sin theta. And cos theta will be one upon root 5. So I get the value of sin theta and cos theta in this equation. Now what they are asking you to find? You are asked to find range, right? Now range is given by u square sin 2 theta upon g. Now over here we'll put u square sin 2 theta as u square into 2 sin theta cos theta upon g. Okay, that is u square, I can write here u square or v square, but I am writing here u square, into 2 into sin theta is 2 by root 5, into cos theta is 1 by root 5 g. Okay, that is gives you what? 4 by 5. Or we get finally r equal to 4 u square upon 5 g. In the options, they have used the symbol v. Okay, you can write 4 v square upon 5 g, but I have used the symbol u. So I get this final answer.
Numerical 17. A projectile has same range r when the maximum height attained by it is either h1 or h2. Then r, h1 and h2 will be related as dash.
Since they have mentioned that range is same for when it reaches height h1 and h2, that means the angles are complementary. If this is theta, then for height h2 it will be 90 minus theta. Understand this. Both the angles are what? Complementary angles. Then only the range comes out to be what? Same. That is R1 by R2 equal to 1. Now H1. How will write H1? H1 is U square sine square theta upon 2G. Okay? For H1. For H2, I'll write U square sine square 90 minus theta upon 2G. Right? Now, sine 90 minus theta is cos theta. So, H2 will become U square cos square theta by 2G. Now I multiply H1 and H2 and see what happens. So it becomes U square into U square upon 4G square into sine square sine theta cos theta the whole square. Okay, I can write like what I write next is I take 1 by 16 and into bracket I multiply by 4. This comes out to be 2 u square sine theta cos theta upon g the whole square. Is it right? You can check it out. And 2 u square sine theta cos theta. 2 sine theta cos theta is sine 2 theta. So I can write 1 by 16 into u square sine 2 theta upon g. Okay. Now u square sine 2 theta by g is nothing but the range. And what we get is r square by 16, or I can write r equal to 4 root h1 h2. This is our final answer.
Now read numerical 20. An object is projected with a velocity of 30 meters per second making an angle of 45 degrees with horizontal. The equation for trajectory is h equal to ax minus bx square, where h is the height, x is horizontal distance and a and b are constants. Ratio of a is to b is dash. G is given 10 meters per second square. Option a is 1:30, b is 30:1, c is 1:90 and last is 90:1.
Now in the numerical, they have mentioned initial velocity is 30 meters per second and theta as 45 degrees. And this is the equation they have mentioned, h equal to ax minus bx square. Now this we have to compare with a general equation for projectile, that is x into tan theta minus half gx square upon u square cos square theta. Okay, you will understand that value of a is tan theta and value of b is जी अपॉन टू यू स्क्वायर कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा. दे आर आस्किंग यू टू फाइंड रेशियो ऑफ ए इज टू बी. सो ए इज टू बी कैन बी रिटन एज साइन थीटा अपॉन कॉस थीटा डिवाइड बाय बी, दैट इज 2u square cos square theta upon g, right? What you get is 2u square sin theta cos theta upon g, right? And sin theta cos theta can be easily written as sin 2 theta. Right? So when you put these values of g, u square and this, the final answer what you get will be 90:1. I'm not solving it, but you can put all the values over here. 2 sin theta cos theta is sin 2 theta. Okay, sin 2 theta is sin 90, sin 90 is 1. Now what remains is u square, that is 30 into 30, that is 900 upon 10, and that is 90 upon 1. That's our final answer. See, let's now talk about vertical circular motion. There is a body moving in circular motion, but it is vertical circular motion. The main thing you have to understand is the velocity will be different at different points. See, at the lowest point velocity will be square root of phi r g, at the highest point it will be square root of r g, and at midpoint will be v is equal to square root of 3 r g. Now where the tension will be high, where the tension will be low. Okay, see, at the lowest point the tension will be the sum of mva square upon r, that is the centrifugal force, plus the weight mg. So maximum tension will come at this point A, but at highest point the centrifugal force will be upwards and weight will be downwards, and that's why tension at point B will be mvb square by r minus mg, and at midpoint the tension will be simply m into vm square upon r. Okay, the weight factor will not be present over here. Now if they ask you tension at any point, any random point, we will use this formula, that is T equal to mv square upon r plus mg cos theta. Okay, now what is cos theta at any point? Suppose over here theta is the angle made by the string with the vertical. Okay, now one more formula you try to remember, and that is what total energy at any point. The total energy at any point will be simply E equal to phi by 2 mg r. Okay, so these are the points we remember for vertical circular motion. Now look at the numerical 50. What is the minimum velocity with which a body of mass m must enter a vertical loop of radius r so that it can complete the loop? Now as I told you, at highest point it is root rg, but at lowest point it should be root phi rg. So the minimum velocity required for the body to complete the loop will be option B, that is root phi rg. If we simply supply root gr, that will not be sufficient, so it will not complete the loop. Understood? So root phi gr is the correct answer. Look at numerical 51. In a vertical circular motion, the ratio of kinetic energy of a particle at highest point to that at the lowest point is dash. Now see,
we are asked to find kinetic ratio of kinetic energy at highest point and ratio of kinetic energy to the kinetic energy at the highest to lowest point. Now, highest point, I have taken point B, and over there I will write half m Vb square. Okay, and at lowest point is half m Va square. Now, value of Vb is root Rg, so it will become what? Half m Rg. Okay, upon half m into 5 Rg. Now, this becomes 1 by 2 upon 5 by 2, right? And that comes out to be kinetic energy at highest point to kinetic energy of lowest point equal to 5. Simply, answer will be 5. I'm sorry, it will be 1 by 5. It will be 1 by 5. Which is nothing but 0.2, and our correct answer is D. Option D is the correct answer. Okay. That was numerical 51.
Now numerical 54. Clearly observe the figure.
Now observe the figure. There is an object undergoing vertical circular motion. Okay. Now, over here, they have mentioned that A is the total acceleration of the body. Okay. And it is pointed vertically downwards. That's the total acceleration. It is 15 meter per second square. Radius of the circular path is 2.5 meter. And angle made by the radius with this vertical A is theta, and which is 30 degrees. Now, as I told you, A is what? Total acceleration. We are concerned with what? Radial acceleration. Finally, we have to find what? V. You have to find V. Now, if I take the component of A along the radius towards the center, it will be A cos theta. So, the radial component will be A cos theta. That is A cos 30. Okay? And A cos 30 is root 3 by 2. So, 15 into root 3 by 2. Okay. This is the radial acceleration. Now, we all know radial acceleration is given by V square by R. AR equal to V square by R. So, V square will be AR into R. Right? Now, what is AR? You substitute 15 into root 3 by 2 into R is 2.5. Right? Now, this can be written as 2.5 by 2, or we can write root 3 is 1.732 into 7.5 into 2.5. Now, when you calculate this, the answer comes out to be V square equal to something 32.5, and V comes out to be 5.7 meter per second. So this is our final answer.
The numerical 55. A stone of mass 2 kg tied to a light inextensible string of length 2.5 meter is whirling in a circular path of radius 2.5 meter in a vertical plane. If the ratio of the maximum tension in the string to the minimum tension is 3, and if g is taken to be 10 meter per second square, speed of stone at the highest point of the circle is dash 5 root 2, 20, 10 or 10 root 3.
Now see, numerical 55, there is vertical circular motion, okay. Radius of the circular path is 2.5 meter. Mass is given 2 kg. G is 10 meter per second square. Maximum tension to minimum tension is 3/1. And V2, that is velocity at highest point, you have to find. Now first of all, we will write the equation for tension. The maximum tension and minimum tension. T max and T min. See, maximum tension comes at the lowest point. So I can write T max equal to M V1 square by R plus Mg. Is it okay? M V1 square by R plus Mg. And T minimum will be M V2 square by R, okay, minus Mg, which is at the highest point. Okay. Now, we also know the law of conservation of energy. The potential energy at highest point is equal to the kinetic energy at lowest point. And so, I can write at highest point, half M V2 square. Okay. Plus 2mgr. Now why 2mgr? Because you can see height is r plus r, 2mgr. Okay, I have taken small r, don't worry. The symbols will not make any difference. 2mgr equal to the kinetic energy at the lowest point, that is half mv1 square. Okay, and this gives you V1 square equal to V2 square plus 4RG. When you divide, multiply throughout by 2, okay, we get this V1 square equal to V2 square plus 4RG. Now, these two equations, when you divide equation 1 and equation 2, what you get? See, T max upon T min will be V1 square by R plus G divided by V2 square by R plus, sorry, minus G. Okay. Now, instead of V1 square, I'll write V2 square plus 4RG. Or when you multiply throughout by R, this becomes what? V1 square plus GR upon V2 square minus GR. And this, put value of V1 square as V2 square plus 4RG. So V2 square plus 5RG upon V2 square minus GR. Okay? Is it okay? Understand? Now, I got these two equations, T max upon T min. But they are given T max upon T min. This is 3 upon 1. So what you get? V2 square plus 5RG upon V2 square plus, sorry, minus GR. Minus GR equal to 3/1. Now cross multiply, what you get? See, V2 square plus 5RG equal to 3V2 square minus GR. Bring GR on this side, it becomes 6GR equal to 3V2 square minus V2 square equal to 2V2 square. And sorry, this is 3RG, huh? I'm sorry, this is 3GR, okay? So, 3GR 8gr equal to 2v2 square. Now put the values of g as 10, r as 2.5 or 5 by 2 I'll take. Okay. And what you get here is 100. Okay. V2 square will be equal to 100 or V2 equal to plus minus 10 meter per second. Okay. This is our final answer.
Let's solve numerical 35 and 36. Okay, so have a look at both the numericals carefully.
Look at the diagram. Body is moving in vertical circular motion. Okay, the mass of the body is 0.5 kg. Radius of the circular path is 0.80 meter. G is taken as 10 meter per second square. Now, the object is at point D. And when it is released from this point, it moves to point C. Now at point D, the velocity is given 12 meter per second. What they are asking you to find, okay? The tension in the string when it reaches the other side, C. Now when it reaches the other side, what angle it will make with the vertical? It will be 90 degrees, okay? And we have got the formula, tension at any point. What? Tension at any point. Tension at any point will be m v square by r plus mg cos theta. Now in this case theta is 90 degrees and we all know cos 90 is 0. What remains is simply m into v square by r. M is 0.5, instead of 0.5 I'll take half. V is what? 12. So 12 square is 144 and radius is what? 0.80. This comes out to be 144 upon 1.60 and we all know tables of 16. 16 nines of 144 and so this answer comes out to be 90 Newton. Okay, so this is our final answer and that is option C. Option C is the correct option. Okay, now numerical 36. A weightless thread can support a tension up to 20 Newton. Okay, the maximum tension of thread can support is 20 Newton. Now you can tell me where the tension is maximum. Tension is maximum at the lowest point. So at the lowest point, the tension, maximum tension it can withstand is 20 Newton. A stone of mass 0.5 kg is tied to the string. Mass is of 0.5 kg. Mass of the stone. Okay. And it is revolved in a circular path of radius 5 meter. Radius of the path is 5 meter. Okay, in a vertical plane, if g is 10 meter per second square, if g is 10 meter per second square, then maximum angular velocity of the stone will be W max. They are asking you. Now we will directly use the formula for tension at the lowest point. Tension at lowest point is given by simply T equal to m v square upon r plus m g. Now m v square upon r stands for the centrifugal force, or in inertial frame of reference we talk it about centripetal force. Now v square upon r can be also written as m omega square r plus m g. Okay, now what I do, 0.4 m is common na, I take on the other side. Okay, So it becomes T upon M equal to omega square R plus G. Now tension is 20 upon 0.4 will be omega square into R. R is 5 plus 10. Right? Now 20 upon 4 is 200 upon 20 upon 0.4 is 200 upon 4, and that is 50. Okay, 50 minus 10 equal to omega square into 5. That is omega square will be 40 upon 5. Right? Now omega will be square root of 40 upon 5. That is root 80. And what answer we get? Omega will be okay. So that's our final answer. 2√2 radian per second. Okay.